Hello, this is the Provoke Prawn, and this is the ASUS ROG Delta S, a headset that'll set you back nearly £200 or $200, depending on where you are in the world. And it's a wired gaming headset from ASUS with a 24-bit high-res audio DAC and the ability to connect to your PC or phone via USB-C. And this is an unboxing and review video. And for reference, I'm using the microphone from this headset right now to do the voiceover for the video so you can get an idea of the quality of the microphone. The microphone itself is also a highlight that I'm going to talk to you about later on because it's a unidirectional mic, but it's also sporting some AI noise cancellation technology. It has noise gate, AI noise cancellation, and other tech that you can adjust within the ROG Armoury Crate software that I'll cover later on. But as I said, this is a high-res headset, so it has drivers that are capable of delivering 20 Hz to 40,000 Hz in terms of frequency response, but it'll also go up to 96 kHz sample rate 24-bit audio within Windows, which means it can deliver some good high quality high res audio. More on the audio a bit later on. But another highlight is that it also will work with your phone using that USB-C cable, and therefore you can listen to high res audio through the likes of Tidal. And that was one of the reasons that the headset was sent to me for testing, because they wanted to make a point of the fact that it works with Tidal and will give you really good audio. And in that way, actually, this headset is fantastic and delivers really good sound for music listening as well. I've been using it with Spotify and Tidal and really enjoying some great sound on my phone and on my PC. The USB-C connection is also very nice. So this is an unboxing video, as I said. I've been using the headset for a couple of weeks, so I'm able to give you my thoughts on it and tell you about what it's like. I'm going to talk to you about what it's like and what's in the box. So one of the things of interest is that inside the box, you not only get the headset itself, which obviously has that braided USB-C cable that you've seen, and an overall sort of nice vibe to it. And as you saw at the beginning, it has RGB lighting, and I'll cover more on that a bit later on as well. And it also has a detachable microphone. Inside the box, you also get ROG's hybrid ear cushions. So it comes with these like faux leather ear cushions as standard, but you also have these hybrid material ear cushions. So you have the choice to switch between ear cups, and that's something I'm quite a fan of. While talking about the ear cups, I will say that they are an interesting shape, as you can see. They're kind of ear shaped in that angle and design of them, and they're reasonably sized. They're not terribly deep, but they're not shallow either. And I've found that they fit nicely on my head. And actually, the faux leather ones, although they make your ears a bit warmer, they do a fairly good job of blocking out external noise. And they're also nicely padded, they're very comfortable to wear. And as you can see, the ear cups twist and turn in a satisfying way, and it's really easy to get this headset positioned on the noggin in order to have a comfortable gaming experience. One thing I will note though is that USB-C cable is fairly short. So I've been using that plugged into my PC for the most part because I have a USB-C connection on the front of my PC, but it is very short, so there's quite a lot of tension there. But you do have the adapter, which I'll show you in a second, that you can use instead. And obviously, it has the benefit of having that short cable means that you can plug it into a phone that's in your pocket, and it has got enough cable to reach from your head to your trousers, for example, so it's easy to plug in. Detachable microphone as well is always a bonus, but there's no 3.5 mm connection options or anything like that on here, which is a bit of a shame. And the microphone is a mixed bag. So as I said, this is a detachable microphone, and it has AI noise cancellation technology within the Armoury Crate that you can turn on, as well as some other settings. I actually have all those settings turned off at the moment for this audio capture. So this is what it sounds like as standard, and I'll show you later on clips of it while I'm playing so you can hear that cancellation in action. But I actually feel like that makes it a little bit worse in terms of the capture quality, although obviously will block out external noise. So if you've got the noisy room or you're bashing on a mechanical keyboard, then that might be a thing to consider. You can see the adapter for the USB-C here, so it goes USB-C to USB-A. What you will note is that is rubber, Not a major problem, but you have this nice braided cable from the headset to the USB-C connection, but then you have to use a rubber one if you only have USB-A on your PC or a laptop, so maybe a downside. But out of the box, a fairly nice looking headset to begin with, and on the face of it, and it is actually very nice. I have enjoyed it for the most part. It is a comfortable headset. There's a nice bit of padding on the headband that you can see there. The ear cups, as I said, of the faux leather ones are really nice. I'm not a fan of the material ones, but what you will see is that they are squishy and big enough to cover the ear. They do a good job of that, actually. As I said, they're not too small, not too big, and they're just deep enough for me, anyway, personally, where I don't feel pressure on my ears from the ear cups or from the drivers. So it's been a comfortable experience with those, and very nice in that way. What you'll notice is there's a lip on the outside of the ear cup and basically hook over the drivers on these headset itself, so you can remove and flip them over. Fairly straightforward, standard design, it's pretty classic, so it's really easy to take these off and put them back on again, depending on how good you are with your hands. I always find these a little bit fiddly, but for a normal person who's less clumsy than me, you'll probably find it quite straightforward. As I said, large 50mm drivers, so they do a good job, and that is one of the highlights of this. If you're looking for a headset that is loud, this thing is incredibly loud. I found I had to run it on some of the lowest volumes, so somewhere around 17 to 25% in Windows, otherwise it just was too loud for me. So if you feel like headsets that you've tried in the past aren't loud enough, and this one you're not going to have problems with, it is ridiculous. It really gets very, very loud, and loudness doesn't necessarily equal quality though, and that is the quality I want to talk to you about. Now, this has virtual surround sound, and it does a good job with that. It is a high-res headset, so as I said, it does really well with music, and I'll show you it plugged into my phone a bit later on. As I said, I've been using Tidal on it and really enjoying the quality of it there. And in music, it's been really rich. And one of the things that you'll note with high-res audio, if you've never tried it before, is that it gives you a new range of sound that you probably haven't heard. So it lets you hear things that you haven't heard before in songs and in games, and experience a wider range of audio, and it can really impress. And I still had that effect when listening to music that I've been listening to for years. You find just a little bit of sound that you've never heard before because it's been mastered at high res and run on Tidal, and then also you get to experience it through these ear cups, you end up getting a really good, rich sound experience. However, I will say that for gaming purposes, I have found that although it's high res, it is a bit on the washed out side, a little bit tinny, and not as bass rich as other headsets I've tried. However, there are a number of EQ settings within the software that I'll show later on. Now you can see a bit of the headband here, nice and extendable metal headband buried within that comfortable fit, and it is very nice in that way. On the headset itself, you have controls that allow for volume control. That volume wheel is a bit flimsy, I'll be honest. I don't really like it terribly. There are three settings for the RGB lighting on the outside of the ear cups: off, on, with a specific color effects, and then a visualizer which responds to the audio captured over the microphone, so it responds to your voice. The volume wheel can be controlled to push in to mute the microphone, and when you do mute it, you get a tiny little red mute light on the mic itself to let you know that it's muted, so it's no longer capturing. You can also control the RGB lighting within the Armoury crate, and again, I'll show you that later on. Although, to be honest, I really don't know why companies bother including RGB lighting on a headset on the outside where you can't see it when you're using it. Seems daft to me, but if you really like some RGB lighting, then this one actually has it in a nice way, and it does look pretty good. And also, it works on your phone as well. So if you've got it plugged into your phone and you're out and about, you can show off your gamery goodness with the RGB lighting shining while you're on the train or just walking down the street or whatever you're doing. And so if that appeals to you, then you have that option. But obviously, you can turn it off as well. So you could have it on when you're in the house and turn it off when you go out, just with a flick of a switch. Faux leather padded headband, again, nice and comfortable. Really good bit of padding on the top there. It sits nicely on the head and is fairly comfortable. I've not had any problems with it. It's been a really nice. It's a good size too, and you can see that it extends nicely and it has that good squishy padding goodness to it. So comfort wise, this has been really nice. As I said, the faux leather ear cups do make the ears a bit warmer, but they do a better job of blocking out external noise than the other ear cups. Now, one thing I've noticed is that I can't get side tone to work, so I can't hear my own voice through the microphone as I'm talking to you now, which for me personally is an annoyance. There is a setting for it in Armoury Crate to listen to the mic, but I can't get it to work. It doesn't want to work for me for some reason. I don't know if this is a problem unique to me or something with the software that needs updating. Bit of a frustration. I really don't like it. However, if you don't want to hear your own voice, it's not a problem. But if you are blocking out external noise, you might find you're shouting a little bit when you're gaming, which is not ideal. You're shouting at your friends. So that is a bit of a gripe. So essentially, so far, what you can see is a comfortable and capable headset. Not wireless, it doesn't have any Bluetooth. I don't know what you'd do if you wanted to connect to iPhone. And it does work with PlayStation apparently, but I'm not sure on what consoles because I've been using it on PC. And lack of 3.5 mm connection might be a gripe for some. However, I do think that working with modern phones using a USB-C connection is obviously a great thing. It also has that high-grade audio DAC. It's a quad DAC. There's a master quality authenticated technology. And I'll leave more information in the description so you can find out more about that and what that means, and also the impact that that has on the sound. As I said, much richer sound in terms of the audio range, but I feel like it lacks bass. However, you can change between various EQ settings to adjust for this and compensate for it, but it is a bit of a problem. However, it does still deliver a fairly decent virtual surround sound, which has been fairly easy on the ears and gives a good positional audio. I've been using it for Rainbow Six Siege and for Assassin's Creed, but with Assassin's Creed I found like it wasn't anywhere near as rich and bassy as other headsets I've been trying out lately, which is a bit of a shame. However, all round so far, a nice headset that you can plug in to your phone and listen to music on with RGB, which I was really surprised that it would run RGB while plugged into a phone. I'd imagine there must be more battery drain on your phone doing so, but it is impressive that it can do that considering usually you'd only see that when plugged into a PC. And also, it is incredibly loud, so even when listening on your phone, you can really crank this thing up. Obviously, don't deafen yourself, but the fact that you can go louder. One thing that you will notice here, though, is that the ear cups, the external side of the ear cups, actually pick up quite a bit of oil from your fingers. You can see some of that in there. This is straight out of the box, basically, but it's already picked up some of the grease and oil from my fingers on the outside, which is obviously not ideal. I haven't got particularly greasy fingers, I don't feel like, so it's something to be aware of that you'll probably need to give it a clean and try and avoid touching those ear cups on the outside when you can, if you want to keep it looking the part. But as you can see, the RGB lighting is actually very nice. If you're into that, there it is in all its glory with the ROG logo and the edging around the outside. And so, pretty decent in that way. And now I'm going to dive into the Armoury Crate software and to show you what it sounds like in game. So, before I go into the Armoury Crate software, one of the things I wanted to show is the ear cup. So, I was talking earlier about how it reacts. And you can see if I turn on a profile view that you can see the lights reacting on the side and reacting to what I'm saying, so you can see them lighting up. So if you're streaming, that might be an option to do it. Although one thing of note is that I have a green screen filter on currently, and actually because of the color of this, it's actually interfering with that. So usually it's kind of a off blue color and it's not brilliant there. So that is a potential issue that's worth bearing in mind. Now here we are within the Armoury Crate software. And you can see that you have settings for audio, lighting, and for firmware. So for the lighting effects, you see the Soundwave one that I was showing, but you can also switch. You have to switch using the hardware button. So if I switch using the hardware button into the other effects, you can go through static, and you can change different colors in between that. You can change to red or blue or green or whatever you want. You can have breathing, strobing, color cycle, rainbow, music and Aurora Sync, so you can have it sync with other devices from ASUS that you might already have, which is fairly nifty. Audio is where it gets more interesting. Now, this is a 24 bits, 96 kilohertz audio headset, so obviously you want to make sure these settings are set to that as default to get the best possible experience. You can also check this within Windows Sound Settings. So if you go into Windows Sound Settings and then go to Device Properties and then Additional Device Properties, and you can see in under Advanced, you can set it to have 24-bit, 96 kHz studio quality audio, and that's the highest you can reach on here. But make sure that those two match up for the best possible experience. Another thing we will note is that you have the option to listen to the device, so you can get it to play back here. I said earlier on I couldn't get it to work, and now it's actually worked while I'm doing this recording, so it goes to show it's hit and miss with that. Other things that you have the sound optimization options, FPS, communication, flat, gaming, movies, music, racing, and RPG. You also have the option to turn on reverb, so it gives you a reverb settings, and equalizer settings, which changes between the music, as well as virtual surround sound. You can also bass boost, add compressor, and voice clarity for when people are talking to you. Those are off at the moment. I'm going to keep those off while I show you, as I move into gaming, what that means. Now, within the microphone settings, you can adjust the noise gate, perfect voice, and AI noise cancellation. So you can turn on the noise gate, that obviously blocks out a bit of background noise. You can turn on perfect voice, which is meant to improve the audio quality of that. And AI noise cancellation, which obviously uses artificial intelligence to improve the noise cancellation and get the best audio out of it. And if I'm typing in there, I'll just type some nonsense onto Notepad here, and then you can hear the difference that makes. So if I'm typing in there, and then I turn these off and carry on typing, you'll be able to hear the difference and what that makes. And this is just a membrane keyboard in the background. It's not a mechanical keyboard, so it's not especially loud, but you can hear the difference that makes. It sounds a lot better with these turned off, I think. That's my personal opinion of it anyway. And now what I'm going to do is I want to show you the difference in sound quality and talk a bit more about that. But one thing to note is the MQA settings here, which is the Master Quality Authenticated Files. So this headset is designed to give you a playback of the original master quality. If you've got Tidal or some other service that delivers files that are mastered at MQA standard, then they will play back at that quality so you can get the best possible audio experience from them. And actually, this is where the headset shines. It gives the best audio from music, in my experience, and much better than in gaming. Unfortunately, I find the games to be quite tinny, washed out, and not as bass rich as I've seen with other headsets. However, you can adjust some of that with bass boost and with the equalizer and with these other settings, but I do feel like there's a lot of messing around with these settings in order to get it right, so I'm going to try and demonstrate that now in a game.
Reinforce the area. Hostiles regrouping.
So here I am in the game now. This is with FPS set on and without any bass boost or anything like that. One thing I immediately notice when playing is that it's very tinny, and although there is some bass to it, the steps are quite light and it's not that great. The 7.1 surround sound is on, so it's not shocking, but it's not as good as it could be. If I quickly go out back into Armoury Crate, and then you'll see the settings we've got. So we've got it set to FPS at the moment. We could put it on gaming and see what changes that makes. Again, it sounds very hollow and it might not come across very well in the video. This is going to vary depending on what device you are using, but it is worth knowing that is potentially a problem. One of the things. Great, they've shot the hostage. So one of the things that I found pretty important to do is to turn on bass boost. That makes quite a bit of difference to that audio range. You'll hear just a little bit there with a lot more bass to it, but just generally it feels quite hollow and tinny, and it's not quite as rich as other headsets that I've tried recently. And you do have a good range of audio though from the high-res audio, so you do hear a lot more, but it's just not as good. And so I feel like there's a lot more of playing around with those EQ settings to get the right sound for you. So there is the ROG Delta S. Would I recommend this headset? I'm not sure. If you are into music and listening to that more than gaming, then you probably will enjoy it. But I've found it to be a bit lackluster in some ways. And there are other more affordable headsets that offer a better quality of sound. However, it is very comfortable and does have a number of nice highlights to it. This has been the Provoke Prawn. Hope you found this video useful. Let me know in the comments if you've got any questions. Thanks for watching.
This has been the Provoke Prawn. Thanks for taking the time to watch this video. Hope you found it useful, interesting, hilarious, or all of the above. Be sure to check out the description for other information you might find interesting, and subscribe and watch these other videos as well that I think might be useful to you. And have a great life.